he remarks dryly. I haven't really mentioned this before, Innes, but Elspeth and Moira didn't get on, to put it mildly. I tell him about the tension in our household that arose from the animosity between Elspeth and Moira. I end with the night Moira flirted with Piers and Elspeth standing over Moira, scissors in hand. Innes looks pensive. I'm quick to leap to Elspeth's defence. Things were different after that night. Elspeth frightened herself. She actually apologised to Moira and got herself referred for help. It turned out that as a child, she'd suffered abuse at the hands of an aunt who looked after her a lot when she was little, which is where her misdirected anger stemmed from. Apparently, Moira bore a strong resemblance to the aunt. I'm not quite sure how to interpret the look Innes gives me. He clears his throat.
Don't take this the wrong way, Ros, but that doesn't sound very plausible.
You think she lied to me? About the therapy? The aunt?
Again, don't take this the wrong way, but Elspeth doesn't seem like the sort of friend you can trust.
Is this because of what she told me about the case in Glasgow? Innes doesn't answer for a moment.
Partly, but also because of the way she behaved towards Moira. Have there been other times when she's let you down?
I tell him the story Elspeth more or less invented about Doug's ex-girlfriend and the baby. You're not the first one to question my loyalty to Elspeth, I admit. Doug didn't like her at all.
That's not surprising,
Innes says. Not just because of the baby thing. I give a sigh. When Izzy was about 2 years old, Elspeth came to stay with Doug and me for a week. Doug didn't want her to come, but she'd just split up with her first husband and I couldn't turn her away. 2 days after she arrived, there was an incident. Our house was burgled and a lot of Doug's photography equipment was destroyed. The police were called, but of course nothing came of their investigation.